What is up, guys? We're here with the SPL Week 9 match between BTB and Sidomas. So BTB is playing on the Sharks. I think they're in the bag at the moment, like 0-2 or something like that, and they have to win this week to still have a slight chance to make playoffs. And Sidomas is on the Runas. I think they have a really good shot at making playoffs. I'm not sure if they're guaranteed in yet. But yeah, BTB brought Stahl. And I'm trying to see if Sidomas can break it. It could be... Is it Bantar or is it Megatar? Basically, one of the two between Kallio or Ladi, one of the two is most likely Choice Scarf. Then... I would think the Landorus is either Z-move or defensive. Like, his team looks a little bit weak to Zygarde, so I would assume that Landorus defensive, yeah. But... If... something can put in work, that would be, I'm pretty sure that's a 5th death Tangrowth on BTB side. If something can break BTB's team, it's maybe a Bantar with getting crunch defense drops. Or getting some Stone Edge crits. See, Kallio lead versus Sableye. Now, this could be a comment Kallio, because he led with it, maybe wanting to comment on the protect from the Sableye. The Reunica is definitely gonna be a comment variant that, I'm guaranteed, like, I'm sure. It's gonna be CM Recover and Psyshock, and last move either Focus Blast or Signal Beam. I have like seen a Sidomas team or like him use a team where it was Signal Beam. So basically, BTB with their predicting a Calm Mind, and I think he predicted the Kallio to be substitute maybe. That's why he didn't Mega Evolve, because he keeps his Prankster and he could Will-O-Wisp if the Kallio had sub. But yeah, Sidomas just Scalded and that did a lot, so... might have to run a Cult real quick if that's Specs damage. Let me do that. Basically, this is gonna be Max Spidef Sableye. That's standard on Stall. You need that to switch into Magma Storm from Heatran. So that could definitely be... there could be Specs Kallio, because that is a lot. I'm gonna Kalk Scarf, but then we're gonna see, obviously, from that. I think BTB has to switch now into maybe... if he knows that it's Specs, then he can go into his Chansey. Yeah, he could go Chansey if he knows confirmed that it's Specs. Or he could predict Sidomas to double on the Chansey and recover. But I have to confirm if it's Specs first before I say anything. So, careful, Sableye Mega, but it's not Mega yet. Sableye... especially defensive. Scald is that's definitely Specs damage. So he does protect to get the Mega up, and now he's gonna either go... I don't know, I think I would have... I mean, protecting, they get some burn chip damage, I guess. That's fine, yeah. Now, either the Chansey or the Tangrowth is most likely gonna come out. So I think Sidomas should maybe double into... he could double into Ferrothorn, or he could double... now, Ferrothorn doesn't get you much. That doesn't get you much. I think double into Tita if you break the Chansey would be cool. Yeah, double into Tita breaking the Chansey. And it works out nicely. So now, this might have superpower if it's Choice Band. Some people use that on teams that are weak to Stall. But yeah, Specs Kallio is actually cool. So Specs Kallio, that means... either the Ladi or the Lando has to be Scarf. Huh. I would think the Ladi Scarf, but... yeah, his team is not that weak to Heatran, so I think he can afford to run a Scarf Ladi. Mega Ladi would be on a team that is weak to Heatran, but between Kallio and Tita, he checks... and Landorus, he can check Heatran fine. So I think he can be Scarf Ladi for sure, yeah. So I'm gonna assume we see a switch from BTB into... I thought into Quagsire. He goes Tangrowth, and he gets... oh, Sidomas gets a crit. That's definitely Fist Death Tangrowth. So now BTB can go on a Quagsire knowing it's locked into Stone Edge. Yeah, basically he went in the Tangrowth that is Scald Ward, Sidomas locks himself into. So that was a fine play. Now Sidomas should double into maybe Furrow on the Tang, on the Quag. Or into like, yeah, something like, yeah. I think Furrow was a fine play. And then he can go for, then BTB is gonna go Zapdos if the Furrow comes out on the Quag. And then Sidomas could maybe knock off the Zapdos leftovers. Or he could double back into Tyranitar and pursue the Zapdos. Those are the plays I'm thinking about. I'm trying to figure out how this game is gonna go. So he goes Pharaoh on the... not Quagsire, on the Jirachi. So BTB makes a mid-ground because that covered the Stone Edge. I'm predicting this... I'm expecting this to be Wish Jirachi, right? If it has Fire Punch, that would be clutch for BTB, but I don't think it has Fire Punch because he has a Quagsire and a Scizor. So his team is not weak to Mega Scizor at all, so he doesn't need Fire Punch on this. So I would assume that... Sidomas is gonna go for a knockoff or power whip. Probably knockoff. BG might want to try to throw up a wish, or he might just go hard Zapdos. He could also go Tangrowth. Because Tangrowth blocks the Leech Seed, but he goes Zapdos because just in case as Illumas goes for Hazards, he needs to go Zapdos to defog them away. Since this Tangrowth is Fist Step, it might be able to deal with Kartana, so the Zapdos might have HP Ice over Heat Wave, I'm not sure. Might still have Heat Wave, because Kartana is like a big threat. But basically, I'm expecting Illumas to switch out here into Reuniclus or Lari. But he stays in to Leech Seed? Okay, that was risky, because I would have scouted for the Heat Wave and gone into Reuniclus or Lari there, probably. I wouldn't have gone Tita, because the Sandstorm was gonna run out. But yeah, now, good play by BTB, knowing that the Tita would come out. If this can live a hit from the Tita, because the last edge was a crit, and it did like, how much did it do? 66 with a crit, so it would do 40-ish without a crit. So you can definitely live any one hit. So BTB could go for a knockoff here, to get rid of the choice band. That's definitely a potential play, but he Giga Drains, okay. So now, this Latios, I think BTB should go Jirachi here, or if he predicts a trick, he goes Sableye, that would make him look like a complete god. If he goes Sableye on a trick, he gets a recover off. That would be super hard, but I'm not sure if he wants to risk that. I think he wants to heal his Sableye on the Reuniclus, because the Reuniclus cannot kill the Sableye from 30%, I'm pretty sure, even if it has Signal Beam. Yeah, it needs to CM up to kill it from there. So that wasn't a Tita there, expecting the maybe Jirachi or Chansey. I'm not sure if he predicted the Chansey, but that worked out really well for Illumas. I'm surprised he went Tita there, because Jirachi came out. Jirachi usually runs speed to outspeed Bantar, so, or naturally outspeeds it even, I'm not 100% sure. So like, I'm a bit surprised by it. So he's just softballed here, I assume, to scout what Illumas locks himself into. That was a fine play by BTB, and now he can go into either Quagsire or Jirachi. But yeah, I'm still surprised that he went Chansey over Jirachi. Maybe he, let me try to figure out what he predicted there. Man, I was trying to figure out, okay, yeah, just softballs again there. Illumas doubles into Lari expecting the Quagsire, okay. Or he was trying to trick the Jirachi. But if Jirachi has Protect, Trick wouldn't have worked with that. Yeah, I think he predicted the Quagsire. But I'm still not sure about... Maybe BTB doesn't need his Chansey to win this game. Probably doesn't need it to win the game. So I think he was willing to let the Chansey get tricked, but he didn't want his Jirachi to get tricked. So he went Chansey early on the Lari. Or he predicted something, but yeah, he makes a fire play, doubling into Sableye on the Ferrothorn. Sableye usually runs a little bit of speed investment to outspeed Ferrothorn, so you can get off a recover when you're low. So BTB is just gonna recover here, and Illumas is forced out into either Keldeo or maybe Reuniclus. You could, if Bantar kills the Sableye from, if Sableye goes for recover here, Bantar comes out and Sableye takes Sandstorm. If Stonehenge then kills from after that, then he could also go Tita here. Because I'm pretty sure BTB will not Wisp here. He's 100% gonna go for recover. So I guess Landro. I would have thought that Keldeo or Reuniclus would have came out. But yeah, now he gets a U-turn here. Or if it's a Z-move Landorus, he can threaten this out. Yeah, he can threaten this out with Z-move. So this could be Skystrike or Rockium. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, like, it's not confirmed yet, but I would, like I said, I think the Lari is Scarf, and the Keldeo was Specs, I calc that. This is Bandit, so this could definitely be Z-move. Otherwise, the Reuniclus would be Z-move, but I would think the Reuniclus would be Leftovers. That's most likely, yeah. So there's probably Z-move Lando. So BTB has to make a decision here. If he goes Zapdos, and this is a Rockium Landorus, that could be really bad. What does he need Zapdos for? Well, he only needs Zapdos to keep off Hazards. And Sableye can also keep off Hazards with his Ferrothorn, since he got that recover off, so he doesn't necessarily need the Zapdos. So I thought he would have gone Zapdos, but he stays in to probably recover. Illumas can U-turn here into his Reuniclus, yeah, because that is immune to Will-O-Wisp. Like, it doesn't care about Will-O-Wisp because it has Magic Guard, that's what I meant. So now Sableye could go for a knockoff to get rid of the leftovers. So I guess he thought it wasn't Z-move Landorus then. I thought it was Z-move Landorus. Maybe it's Z-move Lari? Huh. Or it could still be Z-move on this, yeah. But I really thought it was Z-move Landorus. Or defensive Landorus. I guess defensive makes sense, because like I said earlier, his team is a bit weak to Zygarde for sure. Yeah. His team is a bit weak to Zygarde. So defensive makes sense. But I still would have put probably maybe gone Zapdos there. Like, I'm not 100% sure, but probably would have gone Zapdos there. Well, now BTB can either knock off or recover. The thing is, this Calm Mind's up on the Sableye, and this is a huge threat. It could also have Shadow Ball. I was saying Signal Beam Focus Blast would be the last move. Basically, Unaware Quagsire is nice for the BTB if this has Psy Shock, because then Quack could potentially wall this. But if he didn't have that Quack, and if this has a move to hit the Sableye, then BTB could actually, if CD1s can get rid of the Quagsire, BTB can get in trouble. Maybe that's why BTB went Tang and then Raichu after this was locked into Stone Edge earlier, because he doesn't want to let this Quagsire take any damage, because it could potentially deal with the Unaware. Because it's Unaware, it can potentially deal with the Reuniclus, is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, I haven't uploaded in a few days, you guys will probably obviously have noticed, so this is like kind of, it's kind of like new for me, because I haven't been recording. Oh, I did see it, one sec, let me pause it real quick. Okay, that the sea was really annoying, so we missed a lot of turns. I'm gonna try to scroll back. So he U-turned into Reuniclus. He went back into Landris, expecting the recover, as BTB goes for Protect. Well, we can pretty much say that this is... We can calc from that damage if it's... It's either Scarf Defensive Landris, or it's just Defensive Landris. I don't think that's max attack damage with that U-turn. But yeah, basically, Sidomas is pivoting from Reuniclus into Landris, knowing that BTB is not going to Will-O-Wisp but Reuniclus, so that's cool. And it was left over, so yeah, the Z-move is maybe on the Lardy then, because yeah, it was not on the Landris. Like, it could still be on, like, I don't think it's on Landris, because from that U-turn damage, I think we can tell that the Landris not makes attack, and usually on U-turn, you also don't see Z-move. You only see it sometimes, but I'm gonna have to calc whenever I caught up. So you see a Wish here? Works, okay. So that's cool, now we can just go Sableye, and basically now BTB has Hazards up on the opposing side, and Sidomas only way to get rid of Hazards. The Iron Head's there. Ooh, that was an aggressive play, but basically Sableye was the obvious play there, but he Iron Headed predicting the double. He predicted a double into, I'm not sure into what, but it was a good play. If this doesn't have, yeah, like, I don't think Sidomas can win this, actually, because now Hazards are on his side. This Reuniclus is, like, the only way he can put pressure on BTB. If it has a move to hit the Sableye, that is. If it has Focus Blast and Psy Shock, then the Sableye walls it. But, yeah, he also has a Jirachi, and he has an Unaware Quagsire. So, if this... It either needs, like, Shadow Ball to hit the Sableye and the Jirachi, or Signal Beam. One of the two. If it has Focus Blast, it can hit the Sableye, like I said. But, yeah, like, just... Like, I'm just saying, this might not be my best narration, because I haven't been narrating in a while. But yeah, you guys don't have to worry, I haven't stopped recording. I recorded a lot of games that... I don't know, when my man UB has time, I will pass them to him for, like, lower tiers, and I also recorded some OU games. Still have to re-narrate some of them, did some live, but... Yeah, basically, I'm trying to come back with more live games now. Power Up here? Works. Well, it was... pretty risk-free going Sableye. Like, I personally would have gone still Sableye the first time, but maybe BTB tried to catch a double into Banta. If Banta Stone Edge kills Sableye from 75, then I could understand why he made that play. So I'm gonna calc that real quick. Tyranitar OU Chase Band versus Sableye, that one makes the death, right? So this should definitely do a lot with Edge. Yeah, Edge basically would have killed. So I think he iron-headed earlier with the Jirachi on the Feral Thorn, predicting the double into Titar. Even though he could have, if that scenario happened, he could have just protected with Sableye on the Titar to scout what the Titar locks itself into. And yeah, he would have, Sidomas would have had to go for Edge probably, and then BTB could have gone Rachi or Quag or Tang again. So BTB would have been fine, even like he didn't have to make that play, but it worked out fine, the Iron Head earlier. Like, I mean, it doesn't really do that much, because it only did, like, some chip to the Reuniclus. But I understand why he made that play. I probably would not have made it myself, though. But yeah, now he can probably protect if this Landorus is scarfed. That I'm gonna have to calc the damage from the Landorus. So we're gonna calc U-turn defensive. Yeah, that's defensive U-turn damage. So like I said earlier, this could be scarfed defensive Landorus, or it could be just defensive Landorus, because it doesn't have attack investment from what I thought, and now I have it confirmed here from the calc. that's defensive, because I'm pretty sure that 19 to Sableye. So yeah, Barath could go just back. I mean, I could see him wishing, but probably just going Sableye seems fine. So this is Rock's Jirachi. So it's either lacking iron, it's either lacking U-turn or wish. I would assume it's lacking U-turn. I'm personally not the biggest fan of no U-turn Jirachi, but that means Chansey doesn't have rocks. So Chansey probably has Softboiled, Seismic Toss, Toxic, and then the last move, Heal Bell, is what I would assume. Yeah, yeah, it probably has Heal Bell because it doesn't have rocks. Yeah, that's actually cool. Heal Bell is, in my opinion, Heal Bell is needed on stall. It's pretty important. Well, unless you have a Gliscor. If you have a Gliscor, it could be a bit annoying. But yeah, Sableye is the play there. And now, I assume Reuniclus is going to come back out. But I really don't know if CDMOS has the tools to break BTB's team, because it seems BTB has ways to deal with Bantar. You can check that. You can always go Tangrowth to scout what Tita goes for, and if he didn't get crit earlier, his Tangrowth would have been healthier even. Also, it's still pretty healthy, because after region it's going to be at 80-ish. And yeah, this Jirachi and Quack come in on edges. Quack even comes in on crunch, but going tank first always on Banta is, in my opinion, the smarter play. So he shot Psychic. I earlier said it would be Psyshock Reuniclus, because I think that's the better set, because he beat opposing Calm Mind users like Calm Mind Clefable 1v1. So yeah, I didn't think it would be Psychic, but I also remember CDMOS using Psychic before, but I just said Psychic because I have a CDMOS team that I put in my builder where I remember now. It had a Reuniclus with Psychic, and I changed it to Psyshock. And because I changed it, I thought it was... he goes Feradelf, they're trying to get some Iron Buzz damage, not wanting to get flinched down, because Jirachi already flinched his Reuniclus 3 times. And yeah, I agree with not staying in, because if you get too low, then you cannot switch into Sableye's knockoff. But yeah, just going Sableye, bouncing back the rocks. So you do want to get some leftovers, so it's a fine play for him to stay in there. Now he can go back into Reuniclus, because he wants to get the recover off. BTB could try to, I guess, get a knockoff crit on the Reuniclus to kill it. I'm pretty sure Reuniclus is faster from what we have than the Sableye, right? Sableye is super slow. Yeah, yeah, it's faster. So he goes Zapdos, but Zapdos cannot kill this from here. So Heatwave, Ruth, Defog, and probably... it could be T-Bolt or Discharge. The reason why I say T-Bolt over Discharge is because... on stall, you don't want to paralyze the opposing mons. You want to either burn or toxic them. Like, sometimes para could be nice, but most of the time para is not that great on stall. So you don't want to para mons. But he roosted, so he just wants to keep this healthy. He didn't want to try to crit the Reuniclus. So he knew that CDMOS would be able to heal that. But yeah, now this is most likely locked into Defog. Or is it defense? I think it's Scarf Defensive Lando, pretty much. So Scarf Defensive Lando is cool because it brings some speed control, and it's still able to switch into stuff like Zygarde. And there's a few defensive Landorus scarf spreads. There's one that like runs a lot of defense, so it can even switch into Bandit 1000 arrows. And then there's another spread that just that has 196 speed Jolly that outruns Mega Alakazam. And then you put I think max HP and then a little bit in attack or defense. Probably would be in max HP, rest in defense, and 196 plus speed for Alakazam, because Alakazam looks a bit annoying to CDMOS team. He can play around it, but Mega Alakazam could definitely be a threat for his team. So I think he should run 196 speed Scarf Landro, defensive Scarf. If I'm wrong, Delari's the Scarf, yeah, then that's just me messing up. But I think, yeah, good player to pursuing. Barath got the para, or I should say BTB, got the para on the Tita, that's cool. I could see BTB doubling back into Zapdos to get a roost off, but he doesn't have to make that play. He can also just click knockoff or Giga Drain. So he just clicks Sludge Bomb. What was that predicting? The Ladi? Does he not have knockoff? And he was basically, this is defensive Tang plus Jirachi. Sludge Bomb is for Tapu Bulu, so that's cool. I like stall that doesn't like lose to SD Tapu Bulu, that's really cool. So Hidden Power Fire is revealed, so he's making sure he doesn't lose to Kartana. Heatwave Zapdos, Hidden Power Fire on Barath the West, Assault West Tang, okay. Oh yeah, I think Colin, aka Avon, made these nicknames. So shoutouts to Colin the Goat. He's on the bigs, and he's on my Discord chat, and he's cool. So the Ladi here, I guess BTB could go back to Chansey if he doesn't want his Jirachi getting tricked, potentially. It is Mega Ladi, wow. So I did not expect that. Basically, at first, you guys could hear me thinking that it would be Scarf Ladi, Then now I found out it was it's probably Scarf Defensive Landorus, but I still didn't think that this was Megalady. I thought it was maybe Z-move. But yeah, basically Earthquake, Recover, Draco, and the last move either Psychic HP. It needs Psychic for hitting Toxapex. I mean, he has a Reuniclus. He's not that weak to Toxapex, but so I don't know if he might. Maybe he's giving up Psychic for another coverage move like HP Fire for Ferrothorn. But he could also have Fire Punch on Tita. But basically, BDB can knock off a few times, force this Reuniclus to recover. So he's kind of stalling a recover of this Reuniclus. And yeah, I don't think CDMOS can like win this game. Lati is completely walled by Mega Sableye because they run Speed Death. So like Draco will not do that much and Sableye can just recover it off. Yeah, we have already said the Tita is kept in check. Scarf Defensive Lando is not a threat. Ferrothorn is not going to do anything. It cannot even get up hazards versus the Sableye. The Keldeo specs, BDB can easily play around that as well. I think it was a pretty nice turn where he doubled into Sableye earlier to get it back healthy. But yeah, if I'm not talking, I didn't talk about every turn. Usually I like to like talk about every turn, but also I deceived earlier, which brought me in the bag. That sucked. But yeah, basically, if this doesn't have move to hit Sableye, it's completely over. But even if it has, like, I don't think CDMOS can win. But yeah, Barra's or BTB's, what is his score at the moment? I didn't upload his last two games yet. They will be coming. Just wait a bit. But I need like a break kind of from YouTube. So I still recorded some games, but like I said, I have to re-narrate some of them or send some of them. I sent some of them to my friend UB, my man. So What's going on here? Earthquake. Protect to see what the land locks itself into. Now, I could see Dumas doubling into Tita, breaking the Zapdos, but he doubles into Lati. I guess Lati covered pretty much. Yeah, Lati covered the Zapdos. But yeah, going Tangros, that was a really good play because you don't want to go Zapdos, risking Dumas to double into Tita. So I agree with going Tangros. So you can Draco here, but yeah, okay, Psychics. Basically, Chansey and Sableye both wall Mega Lati, so this is not a threat at all. So he could go for like rocks. No, he had rocks on Jirachi, my bad. I personally wouldn't have gone for S-Toss because if Ferrothorn comes out, then you take Iron Barbs. So I was thinking that you would either go for Toxic or Rocks there, but like I said, I messed up and rocks are on Jirachi. Yeah. So he goes Sableye there to, just in case, Sidomas goes for rocks. Basically, Jarbo does absolutely nothing because Sableye is kinda, yeah, has the same speed tier that the Ferro has. Whispering the Lati is cool for BTB. It kind of just speeds up the game a little bit. It's not like this Lati is gonna beat him. So now, I assume BTB went for recover just to ensure exactly that the Lati doesn't 2-hit KO him with Draco. So I'm surprised he didn't go for protect there, but that was a fine play. Now CDMOS is forced to recover or switch into Reuniclus here. So BTB can just spam knockoff for a bit. How many knockoff PP does he have? 16. And yeah, also, I'm kind of tired, so. And like I said, I haven't been recording in a while, so I hope this narration isn't like super bad. Yeah, I only missed. Yeah, I didn't think it would be Scarf Lati because, like I said, between Keldeo and Tita, I thought, and Scarf Defensive Lando, which is most likely is, I thought he could deal with Tytron kind of fine. But Tytron is like scary as fuck, so it makes sense to have a safe switch into Tytron with Mega Lati. So if Tytron doesn't have Toxic, this is always a guaranteed safe switch into Tytron. Which, Toxic Heatran is still a thing, but it's not that common anymore. Jirachi comes out. Jirachi can get the rocks back up here, as we see it's hidden power fire. Yeah, I talked about that earlier, right? So he's giving up Draco. He doesn't give up Psychic because he still wants to hit Toxapex. Okay. I thought he might not have Psychic because Toxapex. Yeah, I could. Yeah, Pex is still annoying to his team, but he has a Reuniclus, which comes in for free on that. So I thought it was not necessary. And he has Barenta and that could also like overpower it and Lando, but it makes sense to still have Psychic. So he threw up a wish after getting up the rocks. Now he can protect here to look what the Keldeo locks itself into. Pretty simple, pretty easy play. Oh, he doesn't. Oh, yeah, he has protect. For a second, I thought he doesn't. Yeah, so he can just protect it. There's like no reason to risk anything. But I think protect is definitely 100% his play. So you must go double into what? He could go into Ferrothorn here, but it doesn't really accomplish anything. Like, he just can't win. He just can't break BTB's team, pretty much. So, yeah, protecting to see what Keldeo goes for. Hidden power, What hidden power is that? Maybe poison, and he was trying to catch the Tangrowth. The reason I say poison, because he ran out on Kalia to catch Tapu Bulus. Tapu Bulu could be a bit annoying to Sidoma's team, so that makes sense that he's HP poison. Yeah. Because if it's superpower Bulu, then it hits Ferrothorn, and Megalady, yes, can kinda come in on Bulu, but you might want need the Lady healthy for something else. I mean, it has recover, so it can kinda come in reliable on Bulu. But I could still see HP poison being useful to lure Tapu Bulu in. That's kinda cool. Yeah, BTB used that himself with his Poik in SPL this year already, specs Keldeo with HP Poison. I assume it's HP Poison, it could have been HP Ice as well. Nah, I think it's Poison for sure. Because Bulu is pretty common with AV these days, and it also hits Tangrowth, so that makes sense. So Sableye comes out always on Ferrothorn, because you don't want to go Heathers. You never want Heathers to go up. You can just knock off here. I really like that BTB has Wish Pass with Sableye, because if Sableye's recovers ever go low, you still have Wish Pass, and that's just something really cool. When I used Storm myself back in Auras, and I still use it sometimes in Sun and Moon, but not that often anymore. But yeah, it was always cool to have Wish Pass with Jirachi in the Sableye. Or well, sometimes I used Alabamola as well, but let's not talk about my stall times. I'm happy that I've learned other playstyles. Back in Auras it was horrible when I only knew stall for some time. Like, when I started my YouTube, I obviously started other playstyles. But before that, I used stall a lot. And I don't have a problem, like, saying that I used stall a lot. I just... Like, you should stand... Like, if you use stall, you should just stand by it, pretty much. People that use stall and, like, don't stand by it, that's... Don't do that. Like, okay. So pretty much Runicus comes out. The Wish could... I mean, BTB could Iron Head here. He could pass into Sableye. I think passing the Sableye is fine. Like, that means you get something out of the Wish and your Sableye is back at full. But this is... Oh, I'm recording in full HD, by the way. So this... Let me know how you guys like this quality. If you like this way better than the usual quality, then I will try to do this more often. But since my internet is bad, most of the games are going to be in like a less low, like a little bit less quality, because uploading takes forever otherwise. This is going to, yeah, the video is already 27 minutes, and yeah, the uploading this is going to take like at least 1 hour. I hope they, like, I think Sidoma has to forfeit at one point if he, unless he like revealed some hidden tech. Like, I just don't see how he wins this game. Like, his Tita got a crit early on the Tangrowth. I think he has to get his Tita in and fish for crits again. Maybe that could do something, but he's paralyzed now. That means, yeah, since he's paralyzed as well, Tita can't even really break. Like, there's also a chance you get paralyzed on a turn where you attack. There's a chance that Tangrowth outspeeds you? I don't know, because Tangrowth runs minus speed, so it might still be slower, and Para got nerfed this gen. So he just passes into Chansey. I thought he would pass it into Sableye, but it also made complete sense. Now, I would just maybe go into Sableye here, because Sidoma's might want to go into Pharaoh, here, right? You just, I don't... Well, no, he wouldn't go Pharaoh, because it's dead low. So Seismic Toss is a fine play, because the Pharaoh is this low, and he wouldn't go to it. At first, I thought you don't want to Seismic Toss because you don't want to take Iron Barbs. But since the Pharaoh was that low, he wasn't going to it. That was my bad, yeah. So I thought he could have doubled the Sableye by bleeding the Pharaoh, but yeah, he wasn't going to it since it was that low. Now he can just... what can he go to here? This is a bit of a tough position, but I think Sidoma's will probably predict the Tangrowth to come out and will go for... I think he will either go for Scald or HP Poison here. Because Sableye or Tangrowth could come out. If he tries to break the Sableye, he could also go for Hydro Pump, but I think Sableye would live a specs Hydro Pump even. So let me cult that. Try specs. But yeah, people in my Discord were hyped for this match, but BTB pulled up with the stall. So that's 57 to 68. So he could technically go Sableye to scald what this Keldeo goes for, but if he gets Scald Burn, that would be annoying for him. Not quite sure. But yeah, it's already Saturday, and this is only the second Sun and Moon Oyo game this week that has been played so far. I missed the first game, but it was Soulgazer versus, I think, Will of Fire. And I'm pretty sure that at least Soulgazer is not a Sun and Moon. Oh, he attacks the Chansey. He probably decided that he doesn't need the Chansey, but I think he could have potentially gone Sableye. Like, I do understand why he didn't go Sableye. Okay, now his Zapdos can roost up here because the Keldeo is locked in the Secret Sword. He didn't go Sableye because if his Sableye gets low, let's say this goes for like Scald or Pump, then his Sableye would be low, and then the Pharaoh could potentially get up hazards because Sableye doesn't want to come. Because if Sableye is low, it would die to Power Whip, right? So I understand why he didn't want to risk the Sableye, because he didn't necessarily need the Chansey. Because Sableye kind of already walls the Megalody. The Landers is not a threat, the Landers is pretty much walled by these three boys. The Ferrothorn, if the Sableye is healthy, cannot get up hazards. And if it can get up hazards, Zapdos can still defog. But the reason why you want Sableye is so you can keep the hazards off guaranteed. Because if Zapdos defogs, then the hazards on the opposing side are gone. But if you have Sableye to keep hazards off, then there will not be hazards on your side, but you will keep the hazards on the other side. So this is a free whatever he wants to go for. Knockoff Giga Drain. Maybe he doesn't have knockoff. Maybe he has Sleep Powder or Stun Spore, I don't know. I think his last move is Grass Knot. I would assume his last move is Grass Knot, because that still hits Zygarde for a good amount of damage, and he could, yeah, it has to be Grass Knot. Because Zygarde is really heavy, so Grass Knot can break subs from Zygarde. And if you don't have HPIs, you need to run Grass Knot on Tangrowth. That's what people run on stall, yeah. So could see a switch into Ferrothorn here, yep. Just Iron Heads, I mean, that's fine for BDB. Now he can go with Sableye here, Sandstorm ended, so he doesn't have to fear anything. I assume we see a Power Whip or Knockoff from Sidomas, because he wants to stay in with this Ferrothorn to get some leftovers. But I really don't see him winning this game, and yeah, Tita being paralyzed also helps BTB. And if he didn't crit the crit on the tank really didn't matter that much. His tank is back healthy, right? It's at, yeah, it's at full now, regen. Yeah, like, I'm not going into detail into every turn and not describing everything, because it's pretty simple and obvious. Like, I just don't see Sidomas winning this. Like, Reuniclus can't do it either. Spexcalia is the only thing that is like somewhat of a threat if he predicts correct, but even then, BTB has can play around it. So he knocks off and it confirmed Choice Scarf, so at least I got that correct. But I should have realized after this was Scarf that the Lari is Mega, but I thought it was Z-move Lari, to be honest, after this was revealed Scarf. So Zapdos comes out and what, knockoff? Okay. No, so the last move is HPIs on Landris, because it's a Zygarde check. So U-turn, defog, earthquake, and HPIs. So this team is pretty weak to Pinsir, and BTB already used the Pinsir as SPL, so I'm a bit surprised by that. I thought it would have Rock Slide the Landris to check Pinsir. I would have run Rock Slide, earthquake, U-turn, HPIs, and then maybe run defog on Lardy, even though defog on Lardy is like terrible, because it's hard to fit. But yeah, he pursues the Zapdos, which is all cool, but it doesn't really do that much for him. BTB doesn't even need the Zapdos. Like, the Zapdos is just like an extra nice bonus, but it's like not needed to win at all. So he doubles Jirachi there. Not sure what he predicted from what? From, he doubled Jirachi from what had he out? But he can just go back to Sableye here. Yeah, he had a Tangrowth also. He doubled Jirachi, maybe predicting the Lari. Maybe predicting the Reuniclus. Yeah, I think he predicted the Reuniclus there. So he doubles back in the Tita, predicting the Sableye. Good play. He can protect to scout what Tita locks itself into. And now he can go to either Tangrowth. If he's Helmet Tangrowth, he can just go to Tangrowth, or he can go to Quagsire. And Sidomas doubles expecting the Tangrowth. He doesn't want to tank Helmet. Good play, but I don't think it matters. Now BTB can just go back to... No, Sableye is weakened. So this was a good play by Sidomas, weakening the Sableye. So he could maybe Earthquake, but even Jirachi here. Oh, he's burned. Yeah, Jirachi walls this. I forgot about the burn. So since the Lari is burned, Jirachi is free here. So it doesn't matter that Sableye wasn't at full. Okay, since this was burned, Earthquake doesn't even do much to this. So protect there on the Tita to scout what it goes for in case it stays in. He didn't Iron Head in case the Pharaoh comes out. He saves Iron Head PP and he doesn't take Iron Barbs. And now he gets the recover with the Sableye and he's almost back at full. But yeah, I forgot about the Lardy being burned. If Lardy wasn't burned, this could have potentially been a threat, because Earthquake would have hurted Jirachi. But he goes for recover. Now he can... if he wants, he can knock off the band, or he could also protect again to scout. But if he gets parried, like if he protects here and he gets parried, then he doesn't know what Sidomas locks himself into. Also, I haven't been paying attention to decide if there's another secondary game, because sometimes there's two SPL games at the same time. But it doesn't seem to be the case, unless the Gen 3 game is a thing. So yeah, that's what I'm talking about. If he gets paralyzed and he protects, then he doesn't know what the Tita goes for. I assume Sidomas is just gonna crunch. He edges, and BTB is gonna recover. Okay, that's a good play as well, because this way, unless he gets crit there, he lifts any one hit, and he sees what Tita locks himself in. So that was a good play as well. Now he could either recover again or switch into Quack slash Jirachi. Now Jirachi can just go for a wish. Galati is not able, cannot touch this at all. So Sidomas might go back into Ferrothorn here. Oh yeah, Sidomas was able to get rid of the rocks by defogging, but he lost his Lando in the process. And he just doesn't have anything to break BTB's team. So he gets up rocks. Obviously that was the better play. I don't know why I said he should wish. Yeah, you guys can tell, like, I'm not 100% awake, but I think overall this narration is still fine. There's like just some, there's like some little things that I could do better, but it's fine. Like, I'm just, how long have I not been narrating? Like 4 or 5 days at least, so like I'm kind of out of it. But yeah, you guys, some of you guys like the AEV content. Oh yeah, Aaron has their predicting the T-tar. I mean, predicting some sort of double. Either the Reuniclus or the T-tar pretty much. So like Iron Head was relatively risk-free for BTB. It speeds up the game because now the T-tar dies to rocks. He had this game won anyway, but that double Iron Head speeds up the game because T-tar is now dead. That's the only thing that could potentially do damage to BTB with some Stone Edge crits or Crunch crits. So Reuniclus is his last hope, but I don't think he's gonna be able to do it. So he's commanding up, but he doesn't have infinite recover. He only has 3 left. And even if he has Signal Beam, like I said, Unaware, Quack or Jirachi is gonna be able. Like Jirachi can flinch this, or Unaware Quack might also be able to recover stall this Reuniclus. And if it doesn't have Signal Beam, then Sableye just walls it. Yeah, it has Focus Blast. So Sableye just walls it, and this game is over. Yeah, but I wasn't used to this Jirachi having being the rocker and Jirachi not having U-turn. Last stall that BTB used had a powder with rocks, but I'm a really big fan of not having rocks on Chansey because then you can afford to have Heal Bell and Toxic on Chansey, which is pretty good. Because if you don't have Toxic on Chansey, it can be set up for it. I mean, some mons still have Substitute, but if you have Toxic, a lot less mons can use Chansey as set up for it, so I'm a big fan of that. And having Heal Bell is just super nice on the stall team to get rid of potential. Like if Sableye gets burned or something gets poisoned, yeah, it's really cool to have. But yeah, this game wasn't like anything crazy. It was BTB made the plays that he had to make, and he had the good matchup. He had a good matchup, and he got crit at once. That was not game deciding at all, and he was able to break the T-tar with a double Iron Head. That just, like I said, sped up the game. I don't think the T-tar could have won at all. Now we know the entire Reuniclus moveset, so he does have Focus Blast to hit Tyranitar, but that means he cannot hit Sableye at all. Because the other version, like I said, would be Signal Beam. That means if he had Signal Beam, he could have hit the Sableye, but even then I still think he could not have won. Because Jirachi could have flinched this, and also Quagsire had Unaware and could potentially recover spam. And yeah, I think I probably have to agree now that I look. I think I said that earlier already. But yeah, going Chansey on the Lati just in case it had Trick. So yeah, Jirachi doesn't get Tricked. That was a good play. But yeah, we can see the Quagsire eats this up. I didn't know that it would eat that up that well. I thought it would do like a little bit more, like 55-ish. But since it does absolutely nothing, unless it gets crit, I can just recover spam. I guess he didn't want to. I didn't pay attention to the knockoff PP from the stable. Maybe he's low on knockoff PP and that's why he switched out. Completely understandable. Because he kind of has to store a lot of PP. So Psychic Focus Blast command. Now he can. He goes back to this. Okay. I was going to say he could eventually, when this runs out of Psychic and Focus Blast, he could start spamming Earthquake with the Quag. But Sigma's going to forfeit here. He said GG. Thank you guys for watching. I will show you guys the score for the week between the Sharks and the Runas. It should be 2-1 now, and Baron's BTB is gonna be able to pick up the win. And I'm gonna end it here. It's gonna take like 80 minutes to upload with my batnet. Thank you guys for watching. And yeah, if there's no stall and like, sorry BTB, but no stall games are more interesting. He knows that himself. He knows that himself, but I guess he realized that Sidomas has been really weak. Quite weak to stall some of his games. He lost to stall already this SPL once to TDK, so I understand why BTB brought this, but it's obviously more interesting to watch non-stall games. And how do I put this in words? When I use stall myself, I just like, you just see that the free win, blah 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 blah, but it's like way more fun to use other styles. And it's obviously cool if you can use every playstyle because it's harder for your opponent to prep. And okay, also I want to clear this out. I'm not saying BTB is like a stall fag or anything. He can use everything as well. It's hard to prep for him, and that's like I want to say that's amazing. And obviously, he made the right decision. He brought the team, and he saw Sinuous as a weak stall, and he brought it right. But I know that BTB is obviously capable of using anything else. I'm just making clear that, no? I don't want him to get offended here or anything that I'm saying. He's a stall goon. But yeah, I made this way too long already. Peace out, friends. And I will be back later with... What game is today? I think Cory might be playing today. Oh yeah, Eternal Spirit vs. Flaming Victini. I don't know why the scooters are all called Philip this week. This is some troll thing that's going on. But yeah, Eternal Spirit is playing FV, if I'm not mistaken. So that's going to be a hype game that's going to be coming to you guys. And peace out.